Okay, in this video I want to do an example of what's called synthetic division. And synthetic division is when you basically are dividing one polynomial by a first degree polynomial, so x to the first. It may or may not have, you know, a number in there. If it's just x, you would just break things up individually and it'd be pretty easy anyway. So suppose we want to divide, again, x cubed minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 4. We're going to divide that by x minus 2. What you do in this case is, whatever we're dividing by, so notice there's a minus 2, it's x minus 2. We actually take the opposite sign and we'll use positive 2, and that's what you stick outside. And then notice I have 1x cubed minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 4. Notice there's no terms missing. It starts at the third degree, second degree, first degree, and then we just have a number. All we do is we write the coefficients. So 1, there's a negative 2 in front of the x squared. There's a positive 3 in front of the x. And there's a negative 4 just hanging out. And with synthetic division, what you do is, the first term, you just drop it right down. There's nothing to do. And then the idea is we multiply. So I'm going to take positive 2 times 1 and then stick that number in the next spot. So it says positive 2 times 1 will give us positive 2. And then what we do is we add those numbers together in this column. So negative 2 plus 2 is going to give me 0. And then we repeat this process. Now we take positive 2, multiply it by 0, and that's what we stick in the next column. So it says positive 2 times 0 is just going to give us 0. So if we add those together, we'll get positive 3. And then again, I take positive 2 times positive 3. Let me erase my little red dots here. We'll take positive 2 times positive 3. That'll give me positive 6. We add the columns together, and we get the number 2. This last number is going to be your remainder. Remainder. Let's see if I can spell correctly here. And what it says is, in summary, it says we can actually, so the numbers on the bottom are what are important. Okay, so it says we can actually rewrite x cubed minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 4 divided by x minus 2, so I'm going to keep my numbers at the bottom. It says we can actually write that as, okay, so the highest power was x cubed. Make things 1 degree less. So this is going to go with my x squared term, this is going to go with my x term, this is going to be my constant, and again, the other part's my remainder. It says we can actually write x cubed minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 4 divided by x minus 2 as 1x squared plus 0x. So usually 0x, we'll just leave that out. So I'm going to erase it. So 1x squared plus 3. And then my remainder is 2. And we put that over whatever we were originally dividing by, which is x minus 2. And now we have broken up our original fraction into something a little bit more simple, okay? So this would be your solution after you did the synthetic division. Okay? So a useful little trick. One other thing I want to point out about synthetic division. Notice if we look at the thing on top, if I call that f of x, so if I say f of x equals x cubed minus 2x squared plus 3x minus 4. Suppose I wanted to evaluate this. Suppose I wanted to plug in the number 2. Well, it turns out if you plug in the number 2, if you do the synthetic division with x minus 2, if you do that synthetic division, it says whatever the remainder is, that's actually going to be the solution when you plug that value in. So just a coincidence here that I plugged 2 in and got 2 out. But notice if I plug 2 in, I'll get 2 cubed minus 2 times 2 squared plus 3 times 2 minus 4. So this is 8 minus 8 plus 6 minus 4. Well, the 8 and the 8 cancel out. Positive 6 minus 4 is, hey, positive 2. Okay, so synthetic division is actually also a way to evaluate polynomials. That remainder, again, is going to be your solution. And sometimes if you have a real tedious problem, using synthetic division can be useful. For example, if you're plugging things into a calculator. Typically, I don't use it really hardly ever, but that's just a personal preference of mine. So, all right, I hope this example makes some sense. I think I'm going to do one other one as well, just to kind of reinforce this stuff. So if you have any questions, just send me an email.